We have so much, so many more avenues for the producer to make money. It's not only from, of course, theatrical, like you said, is 70%, which
is. If you look at it, it's in proportion to real money, it's very, very, very small. Very small.
Downloads and all that, you know, the physical sales of audio cassette CDs have gone, you know. So those, that was a huge chunk previously.
Now, so you mean it gets offset by the.
Yeah, by the, even not the 30-40% be offset nahi hua hai uska. Jitna CDs cassette se hota tha.
Actually, I think the only source of revenue which is contributing greatly to the producer in the last few years is which has grown. Correct me if I'm wrong. Is the satellite revenue? Satellite rights of films are selling at huge prices, and there's a reason for it. One, the deals are done before. More often than not, they are done before the films are released theatrically. So the television channels, in a way, play blind. They don't know whether the film will
play or not. But they do have a clause. Some of them have a clause that if it doesn't
Secondly, I think the television channels don't really look at the economics when they buy a particular film as I have bought this film for an X amount, so I should make X plus something. Their way of looking at it is how much TRP they get for the screening, and therefore, because those TRPs have a direct bearing on the ad revenue for their other shows. So, I don't think they are looking at it. I think it wouldn't be wrong to say, correct me if I'm wrong again, I think every single channel which is buying films is bleeding. But their profits come in the form of enhanced this advertising rates for the other shows, TV serials, reality shows, etc. Per se, if you were to see how much they pay to films and how much they make from airing or telecasting those films, their balance sheet will be in the red. It's the other benefits that accrue because of getting those films and because of the TRPs that come when those films are telecast. That is the real profit.